In this video, I'll show you how to get started using the DevExpress charts for Blazor. A chart is a great way to help you visualize data. Our charts come with different 2D chart types, ranging from area and bars to pie or donut, and financial views. You'll see how to build a simple Blazor application that uses a chart component to display a 10-day weather forecast. First, we'll add the chart to a page, then customize the axes and series points, then we'll add labels, a title, and a legend. So let's get started. I've already created a new Blazor application and configured it to use DevExpress components. To learn how to do this, you can watch these videos. The links are in the description. The @code block contains declarations for sample data. The type weather forecast includes the three properties date, precipitation, and temperature C, and the method getForecast retrieves a short list of demo objects. Note that any standard .NET collection type can be used as a data source for our chart component. Now I add a DX chart component to the page and bind it to the forecasts array. To create a bar series, I add a DX chart bar series object to the chart. Then I configure the two properties argument field and value field to map to the property names used in the bound data source. I use date for the argument field and precipitation for the value field. All series objects have name properties that are used to identify them in the chart legend. For this series, I set the name to precipitation. I also add a line series for temperature values, and then run the application. The chart generates X and Y axes based on the type of argument and value data fields. The X axis displays discrete values that correspond to dates. The Y axes display numeric values, temperature, and precipitation. The chart shows daily precipitation as rectangular bars and temperature as points joined by line segments. The legend lists all chart series. I'll show you how to customize axis settings to make a series use different Y axes. I create a DX chart argument axis object that implements the X axis, specifying its title and label. Then I create two DX chart value axis objects to generate precipitation and temperature Y axes and specify their titles. For the temperature Y axis, I also specify the name property and the position property. Finally, I set the line series axis property to temperature. If I run the application again, you can see that the line series now uses another y-axis displayed on the right. The x-axis displays dates in short date format. All axes have titles. Next, I'll customize series points. I create a DX chart series point object inside the line series. Set the symbol property to chartPointSymbol.polygon and specify the symbol size. And let's take a look at this in the browser. The next step is to draw labels for series data points. For the bar series, I create a DX chart series label object and set its visible property to true. For the line series, I create DX chart series label and DX chart series label connector objects to display labels and lines between labels and series points. And let's run the application again. As you can see, some point labels overlap. But you can avoid this. Back in Visual Studio, I set the chart's label overlap property to chartLabelOverlap.stack. And rerun the app. Now these point labels are shown in a stack formation. To add a title and subtitle to the chart, I create DX chart title and DX chart subtitle objects and specify their text properties. And here's the title in the browser. Finally, let's customize the legend. I create a DX chart legend object and specify the following properties: orientation, horizontal alignment, and position. If I run this one last time, you'll see that a legend is aligned to the right and displayed above the diagram area. And that's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial on the DevExpress Blazor chart component. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. If you have questions, comment below. You can also check out our documentation for more videos. And don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell for more DevExpress content. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.